The lander is now in space, and we're going to show it to you. This is the first photo of the Peregrine captured in space, and Astrobotic representatives say it is also the first visual that confirms that there is a problem with its propulsion system, something they discovered a few hours after liftoff.
5, 4, 3, we have ignition and liftoff of the first United Launch Alliance Vulcan rocket.
From Cape Canaveral, Florida, but guided from Pittsburgh.
And we have separation of both SRBs, everything looking good.
The Vulcan rocket launched with Astrobotic's Peregrine lander on board and excitement from all around.
It's a dream. This is the moment we've been waiting for 16 years.
But a few hours in, Astrobotic confirmed from mission control on the north side that an anomaly prevented the Peregrine from establishing a stable sun-pointing orientation, which is necessary to keep the batteries charged. But then came another victory. Astrobotic posted, quote, "The team's improvised maneuver was successful in reorienting Peregrine's solar array towards the sun. We are now charging the batteries." But after further evaluation, Astrobotic found the problem was in the propulsion system, which they say threatens its mission to soft land on the moon, where instruments on board were to gather and send back data. Astrobotic representatives said they were working to stabilize the loss, adding, quote, "We are currently assessing what alternative mission profiles may be feasible at this time." That work is still underway inside the Pittsburgh company's headquarters, where experts say whatever happens, history is being made.
Space is hard and things can happen. And so the idea is, like, if something does happen, they're going to keep trying. Like, they have other stuff. There's other, they don't go away as a company. Like, they continue. They just realize this is like that first really big step towards making the moon so much more accessible.
Astrobotic officials confirmed, despite the issues with the propulsion system, the Peregrine's batteries are now fully charged and they are performing as many operations as possible while they determine what's next. Live on the north side, Marcy Cipriani, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.